if a treatment is truly effective, then shouldn't the rates of disorder and disability as a direct consequence of that illness be decreasing rather than increasing? And that's why we need to consider the role that medications might be playing in some of these outcomes. If we take any class of medication, antipsychotics, anti-anxiety medications, antidepressants, the pattern is the same. In the short term, these treatments are often very effective, but in the long term, they aren't. And in some cases, they're making life worse. If we look at, for example, studies that have been done on ADHD children treated with stimulants or Ritalin, in the short term, they are better and responding than better responders than any other form of treatment. But in the long term, they fare less well than children who were never prescribed these medications. Another study showed that despite our ever-increasing reliance on antidepressants, the recovery rates and relapse rates are no better now than they were 50 years ago prior to the advent of these medications. And children with depression who are treated with antidepressants are 3 times more likely to convert to bipolar disorder than children who were never given these medications. And people who are randomized to stay on their dose of antipsychotic medications are less likely to recover from schizophrenia in the long term than people who had been randomized to a dose reduction or complete elimination of the drug. And I can show you more and more studies all highlighting this same bleak picture. So, pretty depressing.